Here for the amendments, we had discussed how to carry the details from the jurisdiction and fill the application form and submit to PS. Now we'll go to the execution part of the amendments, how you will be executing the amendment job. So initially you'll be getting notification from VARAL, and then based on the notification you'll fill all the application forms and you'll prepare all the documents required. And then if it is non-portal, you'll get fill it manually, and if it is portal, you can update all the required documents over there. Now here, then once you once all the documents are ready, then you'll submit it to client for client signature. So you'll submit it to VARAL, and VARAL you'll submit it to PS, and PS will submit it to client, and then client will make all the signature and send it back. Now here, once when they send it back, so you'll be also filling the documents required form over there, so in that you can mention how the client has to send this. Should they send it through email or should they send it through courier? So once you mention that, the client will send that, and VARAL will request for the payment for now. Later on, this step may be modified, but for now, VARAL will make the payment to the jurisdiction. We will initiate the payment, everything. And then here, if the original documents are required, then VARAL will take care of submission of the documents. And if the copy of the documents are required, then JEA themselves can submit all the documents to the jurisdiction. That will be mainly through portal. Through portal, all the documents should be just uploaded over there. So you will be receiving all the documents from the client, and you can upload all the documents over there. So now we'll go in details on filling the application forms. So if you go in detail, so VARAL will send a notification to JEA when a payment is received from client. So the notification will have company details, job details, and link for folder. So you click on this folder and you'll go to the that particular company. So you'll find all the documents which you had uploaded earlier, that is all the application forms and all the document required details and quotation over there. Now what you can do is you can start filling all the application forms which are available over there. Once you fill all the application forms which are available, and you will have to prepare all the documents. So here you'll go to the folder and fill all the application form. And whenever there is an amendment, there are some documents which the jurisdiction requests, that is the board resolution. For example, if it is a change of shareholder, then we need a board resolution from the company stating that, with all the details of the change of shareholder. And then there will be authorized person, the person who will be collecting and submitting all the documents. So there should be an authorized person. And same way, there can be multiple such documents. So now here, few jurisdictions, they provide a template for these documents, and you just have to fill the template and you have to get signed from the client. But few jurisdictions, they doesn't give any template for these documents. They just mention like board resolution. So when you ask them if there's any template, they might say, okay, you can just prepare a board resolution with the company letterhead. In that case, what you can do is, when you go to your training manual over here in your JEA manual, here like we had the quotations earlier, quotations where you go here and prepare quotations, same way we have all the documents like board resolution, authorization letter, and we'll be keep adding all the required over here based on the requirements. Now for example, if the board resolution is requested, you can go here, you'll find the board resolution for change of activity separately, board resolution for change of director separately, board resolution of change of manager separately, board resolution for change of shareholder separately. So now for example, consider that you are requesting for board resolution of change of shareholder. You will go here, you will open this file. So this will not be, you will not be able to edit this file, okay, because it's not shared. So you can do one thing, you will get this. So like you did for the quotation, you can make a copy of this, and then you have to rename it. When you rename, you can follow the same structure which I told you earlier, that is you'll put a company name, jurisdiction, and what is the document. This document is board resolution for change of shareholder, and then put the JEA ID. So once it is done, you can open here. So this is a Word format, so you can open it in Google Docs. You can just click over here and you'll be getting one more doc in the next tab. So over here, when you open this, all those fields marked in red should be updated. So here for example, this is a board resolution for some company called VARAL Consultancy, for example. So you'll put the VARAL Consultancy name over here, and then you'll put what, which is a jurisdiction, DWC, Dubai South, Ajman Prison, whatever the jurisdiction, you'll put it over there. And you can mention this is an offshore company, and if it is onshore, you can mention it onshore. So where can you check that? In the contact details of jurisdiction, you have the details also if it is offshore or onshore. Then the license number, you can get it from the previous year license of that particular company, so you can put the license number. So same way, you can edit all the details. So here, when you edit all these details, you'll not be having most of the details. For example, not be having the place or you'll not be having number of shares that is to be transferred, you'll not be having what is the value of that shares, and you'll not be having the details of who is being removed and the passport details and who is being added, newly added. So you'll not be having all these details because you'll be getting only notification saying that please start the execution. Now here, whenever you don't have any details, what you can do is, whenever you don't have any details over here, you can directly send an email to the personal assistant. So in your notification, you'll also know which personal assistant team is dealing with that. So you'll have an email over there saying that Varal PA team 1, Varal PA team 2. So you can directly send an email to them asking all these details. So you can make a list of details what you need. You need to know how many shares are being transferred, what is the value of the shares, and who is the person whose shares are removed, and their passport number, and the new person to whom the shares are given, and their passport number. So you can list down, and here transferor, transferee, this you can update, both are same. And director, what all the details are marked in red, and what all details you don't have, you can put an email to the PA team to collect these details from the client, because you will not be able to contact the client directly. So PAS will collect all the details from the client and reply to you. So you can put up all the details over here. So whatever marked in red will be edited. So same way, all other documents will be available. So I'll just remove this. So you can always make a copy of this. So here in all the documents, so for example, if it is board resolution of change of activity, it is not updated yet. So it should be updated soon. So what you can do is you can put up a message in JEA WhatsApp group where the task centers are available. You can just put a message that there is no board resolution for change of activity, please update that. So when you say that, they will update this, so you can make a copy and then prepare the document. So whatever document you think it is missing here, you can just inform in the JEA WhatsApp group. So they will be updating all those details over there. So this is how you'll be preparing all the documents. So you'll be preparing all the documents and you'll be filling the form which I told you earlier, and you'll submit the document so that all the documents will be received by PS, and PS will send it to client and client will sign it and send it back to you. So as I told you earlier, the client will be sending either through email so that you can directly submit in portal, or else they'll be sending through courier so that Varal will take care of the submission and collection of the documents. So now if you check over here, if for example in the portal, you can just log in and get all the details over there, but still I'll just go through a portal, RAC ICC portal. So what you can do is, for example, you can go to the contact details, and even here the contact details are not updated for now. So what you can do is you can put up a message in WhatsApp group, that is Varal JEA WhatsApp group, saying that there is no contact detail available, so our Varal colleagues will update it from here, so that is not an issue. So for example, RAC ICC, you have the username and password, so you'll go to the link, you'll copy the username and password, you'll paste it here and then login. So when you login, for example, here all the services are here, company services. So what are you looking for? So you are looking for amendments, right? So company amendment, here there is an option company amendment. So it is open a business, this is for new companies, open company amendment, liquidation and charge, this is for closing the company, and re-registration is if the company is stuck off and they want to re-register, and renewal is an option over here. So here in this video we'll focus on company amendment, so you can click over here. There are options: transfer shares with changes of to director to secretary, transfer of shares, change of share capital, all these things. So you can select the option from here, and in case if you have any doubt on this selection, you can contact WhatsApp group, you can contact Varal through WhatsApp group, JEA Varal JEA WhatsApp group, or else you can even put a message to PS through email and ask them, so what exactly are they looking for. So if you have any doubt over here, you can directly ask them. So director, secretary, or change of transfer of shares, if you click on that, you'll get further details. So you can put the customer name, company name, you put all the details, and then initially you'll be getting the costing details. For example, if you put some company as okay, so for example, this company details, amendments required. For example, you can put the exact details over here. meeting date type of request, normal, don't select urgent because the urgent will cost you more, always select normal. And in case if it is urgent, you will be informed, only then you can put urgent. Signature, verification status, witnessed by agent, so you can select always witnessed by agent. Because there are two options for RAC ICC, we are the register agent, so all the details, all the amendments or new company formation renewal can be done only by the agent. So all these documents should be witnessed by agent. So if you said documents notarized, that means it should be notarized from embassy in the parent country and again embassy here, again Ministry of Foreign Affairs, all these things. So you better select witnessed by agent. This is the only option that you can select. And then you'll put all the details over here. It is already there. Then you can put the email. That is always put sales email. sales@varaluai.com. And you can put the number as 0528101914. It is already mentioned in the contact details of Varal contact. You can put the same details. So when you submit this, error is company selected to the service is inactive. So you can select some other company because this company is not inactive to make this a change of shareholders. So you can select some other company for whichever is, for example. Then when you click on next, they'll ask for all the details verifying, so you can click on next. And here you'll be getting the details of, you'll be updating all the details. It is already there, you don't have to make any changes over here. Okay, so if because we requested for transfer of shares, we have to update the details over. So when you go on here, you'll be getting the invoice, that is the costing details, so that you can get the invoice prepared, that is the quotation prepared. And then once the payment is made from the jurisdiction, you can go here and then update all the details, and then you can submit it for the change of shareholders. So this is how you'll be doing the amendments. So this is in all the portals, you can go there and look for amendments, and then you can proceed with that. So this is how you will be executing the amendments. So where you will be collecting all the details, prepare the quotation, and once you get a notification for execution, this is how you will be executing it. So make sure that, for example, if you don't get any, for example, if there is a jurisdiction that doesn't send you a board resolution, you ask them, you send an email and ask them for a template for board resolution. So they will send a template, or else they'll tell you like you can prepare it by your own. If you are going to prepare it by your own, it should be available in the JEA manual. And if it is not available here, then please update JEA Varal Task Varal WhatsApp group, Varal JEA WhatsApp group. So they will update the folders or files over here. So this is how you will be executing. So once it's submitted, you can follow with the jurisdiction for the completion of the job. And once it is completed, the documents, most of the documents will be collected physically. So Varal will take care of collection of these documents. And if it is through email, you'll be getting the email, so you can forward that to Varal. So this is how you'll be executing the amendments. And one more update is like, this will be the Varal 1.0, where it is the first version of JE execution. So based on the system improvement required, we'll be updating Varal 2.0, that is a updated version of this JEA execution. So that might look more comfortable for you guys. So you are always welcome to suggest any system improvement on these processes required.